Performance USA, the greatest entertainers in America, is requested by you, the fighting men of the United States Armed Forces throughout the world. Command Performance, presented this week and every week, till it's over, over there. Okay there, gang, grab yourself a round-trip ticket to Hollywood and catch the world premiere of another big Command Performance produced by a special service in Los Angeles, USA, and directed by the biggest stars in the nation. The joint's really packed with celebrities tonight, and everything's on the house, so bang open them swinging doors and let's settle down to some steady entertainment for the next half hour. Each one of you has your favorite pinup girl, but all of you want the girl with the most famous pins in Hollywood, and here she is, your mistress of ceremonies, Marlena Dietrich.
Go see what the boys in the back room will have, and tell them I'm having the same. Go see what the boys in the back room will have, and give them the poison they name. And when I die, don't spend my money on flowers and my picture in a frame. Just see what the boys in the back room will have, and tell them I sigh, and tell them I cry, and tell them I died of the same. All giving this the GI treatment. I know what the boys in the army would have, and brother, we're in on that game. I know what the boys in the Navy would have, and mister, that's more of the same. They ask for girl, don't think it's funny. Remember Shakespeare said, what with a dame? Just see what the boys in the service will have, and tell every man from factory run that we've tried to get him the same.
Hello, fellows. This is Marlena Dietrich seeing what you boys in the back room will have and seeing that you get it. Before the international floor show begins, I'm sending love to the Gunners and the Wolfhounds at 2-5, to Private Andy Vavrick, and the mob at 556. Greetings to Pete Alexander and that India workshop over in Quetta, India, and to Johnny Ellis at PT Base PO318. Hello there, Corporal Bob Wisconsin, and the nest of scorpions at 485, listening on a captured German radio. And for 10,000 O'Briens and O'Toole's and O'Reilly's and Notre Dame's fighting Irish over in Sicily, here's a song as Irish as Petty's Pig, O'Donegal, sung by lovely Shirley Ross.
Three years ago this very night, I left the port of Cork, and on a ship from old Erin's Isle, I landed in New York, without a friend to greet me there when a stranger on the shore. But I wore an honest Irish heart and fortune came galore. Well, here I am back again on dear old Erin's Isle, and my friends, they meet me on the quay and they greet me with a smile. There was faces there that I surely forgot, for I was so long away. But my mother, she introduced them all, and this to me did say, shake hands with your Uncle Mike, my girl, shake hands with your sister Kate, and here is the boy you used to swing with on the garden gate. Shake hands with all the neighbors and kiss the Barney Doll. You're as welcome as the flowers in May to dear old Donegal. Well, they gave a party when I came back, and they came from near and far, and the road was lined for near a mile with Ivy Johnson cars. The whiskey flew like buttermilk to set our heads a whirl, and the piper played an Irish tune to greet the Yankee girl. Tomorrow out of the church I'll go, and wedded I will be to my tall and handsome Barney Bond, sweet Mickey McGee. For Mickey was true and faithful to his collie nor the sea, and we'll join the harps and shamrocks to the stars of liberty. There came Granigan, Flanagan, Milligan, Gilligan, Duffy, McCarthy, Malaggy, Mahone, Rafferty, Laverty, Donnelly, Connolly, Dooley, O'Hooley, Madonley, Malone. Madigan, Shadigan, Lanahan, Flanahan, Pagan, O'Hagan, O'Hulahan, Flynn, Shanahan, Lanahan, Fogarty, Hogarty, Shelley, O'Kelly, McGinnis, McGinn. Shake the hand of me, Uncle Mike, and the hand of my sister Kate, and I'll hug and squeeze as much as I please the boys at the garden gate. We'll invite all the neighbors to our wedding, great and small, and we'll live content and pain all right. In dear old, dear old
Well, fellows, a couple of lady piano movers just wheeled in a big concert grand, and we have a very pleasant surprise for you. Many of you know the brilliant work of one Solita De Solis, Italian-born concert artist, now an American citizen, who is creating a new trend, turning our familiar old songs into Carnegie Hall stuff. Fellows, Command Performance presents Solita De Solis. Mr. Solita De Solis, just to give the boys a rough idea of your treatment of their old favorites, would you give us a sample of Swanee River? See, fellows, now settle down and get a load of Mr. Solita De Solis putting white tie and tails on your beloved tune, Night and Day. Thank you. Thank you, Zolito di Zoli. Next command performance sends greetings to the Pill Rollers, alias the Brooklyn Dodgers at 2-7, including Spellman, Boots, Lipstein, Levy, and O'Reilly. Also to Sarge Carl Monday at 2-4. The 26th Portable Hospital at 922, and the Gas House Boys at 668. Hello to Private Guadalupe Gonzalez at 954, and Rudy Barunca in the kitchen at 928. We'll take no responsibility for our next guest star. It's a toss-up whether this man is a character actor or just a character. But he's hot stuff with the AEF. And here he is, Wacky Zero Mustel.
I come up here tonight to tell you what's going on this amazing phenomenon known as the radio. Seems that there's a chap on the radio whose name is J.J. Agony, and he runs this Goodwill Hour, and thousands... Mental. Thousands of people come up and ask him all kinds of questions, and he's been successfully answering their questions for 2 years until this one character came up and asked him a question which Agony couldn't answer, thank God. He said to him like this. Mr. Agony, my name is VP. And I came to this country when I was a boy of two, and I opened up a little candy store. The store flourished. I married a good woman. As a result, I achieved 4 children. A good woman. And it all happened some 2 years ago. I was walking in the streets when a safe fell on my head. Naturally, I was taken to the hospital, a sick man. While there, I learned that my hitherto faithful wife, Bobo, had left me. She had taken the 4 boys with her, the one with the 2 heads and the other boys. She had taken my shaving kit, my personal belongings, my valuables. I soon got well, and while walking out of the hospital, I slipped on the steps, and I broke both my legs. So I went back into the hospital, and while there, I learned further that my store had burnt down. My insurance had lapses. I have nowhere to go. I have no one to turn to. So I come to you, Mr. Agony, with this. What I want to know is, have I got a problem? or in the words of the immortal poet, philosopher, educator, James Durante, who once told me in E flat this. So I goes into this dentist office, and there's a guy sitting in a chair, and I notice that one side of his mouth is perfect, but on the other side I notice that he's got a one tooth, half tooth, no tooth, the whole tooth, one tooth, a half tooth, no tooth, the whole tooth, and one tooth. So I goes up to him and I says, I don't understand. One side of your mouth is perfect, but on the other side I notice that you've got a one tooth, a half tooth, no tooth, a whole tooth, one tooth, a half tooth, no tooth, a whole tooth, one tooth, a half tooth, no tooth. So he said to me, it is true, my friend, that one side of my mouth is perfect, but that on the other side I've got... A one tooth, a half tooth, no tooth, a whole tooth, one tooth, a half tooth, no tooth, a cavity, one tooth, a half tooth, no tooth. So he said to me, why do I need both sides of my mouth perfect when I speak out of one side of my mouth? But I still don't understand. Why should one side of his mouth be perfect? On the other side he's got... I want to have to know.
Well, men, hundreds of you all over the world
write letters to Martha Tilton, care of Command Performance. And we, Martha, has dropped in tonight to answer a rather strange request. Tell them about it, won't you? Martha Tilton.
Well, thank you, Marlena. And hi, fellas. The radio operators with the Fleet Marine Force ask for goodbye now. So does the Chamber Music Society of Lower New Guinea. And so do the fellas at 860. And I'm really scared about disobeying your orders, but here's the reason why. About 40 RAF boys got together and wrote as follows. Dear Command Performance, America has great songwriters like Johnny Mercer, Hoagy Carmichael, Cole Porter, Rodgers and Hart, and we love their music. But do you know who the world's greatest songwriter was? Good old William Shakespeare. So, Martha, please get a Dixieland combination and do Shakespeare's lovely song, It Was a Lover and His Lad. Okay, fellas, here it is. It was a lover and his lass with the hay and the hoe and the hay nonny no that o'er the green corn field did pass. Springtime, the springtime, the only pretty ringtime, when birds do sing, hey, ding, a ding, ding, sweet lovers love the spring. Between the acres of the rye, with the hay and the hoe and the hay, nonny, no, these pretty country folks would lie. Springtime, the springtime, the only pretty ringtime, when birds do sing, hey, ding, a ding, ding, sweet lovers love the spring. Carol, they began that hour with the hay and the hoe and the hay, nonny, no. Now that life was but a flower. The springtime, the only pretty ringtime. When birds do sing, hey, ding, a ding, ding, sweet lovers love the spring. Therefore, take the present time with the hay and the hoe and the hay, nonny, no. For love is crowned with the prize. In the springtime, the only pretty ringtime. When birds do sing, hey, ding, a ding, ding. Sweet lover.
Thank you, Martha Tilton. I can just see Johnny Mercer at the local library tomorrow morning, going through Milton, Chaucer, and Dickens for new song material. Well, fellows, moving on to a few score and seven more APO and FPO numbers, we are delivering the young lady who has jumped into the top ranks of your favorite girlfriends during the past year. Gentlemen of the AEF, another command performance for Ella Mae Morse.
Thank you, Marlene. And hi, fellas. You know, I'm packing around a bit of that terrific GI mail of yours, so let's play a neat 30 seconds of post office. A quick hello to Snowy Beck and Gunga Den Holers, two Australian helping guards. They're guarding an important sea lane somewhere between the North and South Poles. I'm also calling on E.H. Max Signer of the Navy to say Max. He asked command performance for lots of things, but believe me, you're the first one to ever ask for a red-headed nurse. Regards from Corporal Jerry Wilhelm to 15 Yankee Dandies at 715. Hello, Alaska, and the gang at Hot Springs, Iceland. Ditto to Greenland and the Aleutians. But, fellas, I'm running into overtime in the talk department, because my main message to all of you everywhere is, aided and abetted by those five Pied Pipers, I'm joining up with the silver-toned tenor voice of Johnny Mercer for a turn on one of your favorite ditties, Blues in the Night.
My mama done told me when I was in knee pants My mama done told me, son.
A woman who'll sweet talk and give you the glad eye. But when that sweet talking's done,
a woman's a two-faced, a worrisome thing who'll leave you to sing the blues in the night.
Now the rains are falling, hear the train are calling, hoo-wee.
My mama done told me,
hear that lonesome whistle blowing across the trestle, hoo-wee.
My mama done told me,
oh, hoo-wee-da-hoo-wee.
Oh, clickety-clacks echoing back the blues in the night.
The evening breeze will stop the trees to cry, and the moon will hide its light. When you get the blues in the night,
take my word, the mockingbird will sing the saddest kind of song.
He knows things are wrong, and he's right.
From Natchez to Mobile, from Memphis to St. Joe, wherever the four winds blow.
I've been in some big town, I've heard me some big talk, but there is one thing I know.
A woman's a two-face,
a woman's a thing who'll leave you to sing the blues in the night.
So let me give you fair warning, you may feel fine in the morning, but look out for those blues in the
Thanks to the Pied Pipers, Ella Mae Morse, and Johnny Mercer. Well, fellows, a flattering number of you have written to me in care of Command Performance, asking for three songs. I've sung these three numbers at so many army camps that by now the music looks like the end of a three-day pass. One of these is See What the Boys in the Back Room Will Have, and I got safely by that early in the show. The other two are Falling in Love, which I can't sing tonight because the notes are so worn the band can't see them. And this one, dedicated to that girl who has your picture on her vanity, the girl who each night says to that picture, you've got that look.
You've got that look that leaves me weak. You with your eyes across the table technique. You've got that look between the lines. You with your let's get more than friendly design. I should be brave and say, let's have no more of it. But oh, what's the use when you know I love it. You'll only kill my will before I speak. So turn on that low-lead hook, that look that leaves me weak. All I do is dine with them and split a pint of wine with them, respectable as can be. Yet here's what they say to me. You've got that look, that look, that leaves me weak. You with your eyes across the table technique. You've got that look, between the lines. You with your let's get more than friendly design. I should be brave and say, let's have no more of it. But oh, what's the use when you know I love you? You'll only kill my will before I speak. So turn on that low left hook, that look that leaves me weak.
Well, men, the cop of the night beat will be coming along in a second, and if he finds our lights on, he'll have to make an investigation. So we'll ring down the curtain on another command performance for all of you men and women who will be ringing down the curtain on the Axis. This is Marlene Dietrich saying, thanks for those letters, affectionately yours, and write again soon, and so long from the USA.
This is Ken Carpenter with that closing remark to the effect that command performance is arranged in cooperation with the Hollywood Victory Committee and is produced for you men of the Armed Forces of the United Nations by the Special Service Division of the War Department of the United States of America.